In this video, we shall talk once again about checklists, test cases, and test suites, now by example. We've already seen all those ideas with slides, and here we shall use our Word document and not only talk about checklists, test cases, and test suites themselves, but once again we shall review several stages, several steps on how to do it, how to create that all. So, the first idea. When you are working with test cases, you have to read and improve the requirements. This was in one of the previous chapters of our training. The next stage is creating checklists. Once again here, just a reminder of some approaches to checklist creation. Using the requirements from our educational project, we shall create such checklists. For basic functions, functions used for most users, and other remaining functions. When we are speaking about basic functions, just remember we are talking about some file converter, some text converter. We need file processing, and really those are the main ideas. To start the application, to check if it performs basic operations, and to stop the application. And yes, that's all for the smoke test here. This is a kind of checklist for the smoke test. The next are functions used by most users in their daily work. So here we also have configuration and start, but with several more specific actions. Maybe without all the parameters, with some mandatory parameter omitted, with wrong parameters, file processing for more specific cases, some issues with file access, and here we stop the application in different ways. Checking the log, checking the performance, and that's all for typical functions. And of course, some applications have other not so really important functions, and we may list it in the checklist for the extended test. So, if we are scrolling backward, here we see the following checklists. All these are checklists. This is the checklist for the smoke test. This is the checklist for critical path test. Here it ends. And this is the checklist for extended test. Here it ends. Then we are creating test cases. Here are several samples. Each test case, of course, should have an ID, some priority information, link to the proper requirement, module and submodule, that's part of the applications. It has the title, it has several preparations here, and then it has steps and expected results for each step. And here are two more examples. If for some reason this document is not accessible for you, you may just pause the video and read the example from the screen. This is the second example, and this is the third example. And once we have a lot of test cases, let's imagine that this is the list of many, many test cases we already have. We may need somehow organize this list, somehow combine subsets from that list. Such subsets are test suites. For instance, we need tests for the error handler submodule. If we need such set, we just somehow apply a filter on the submodule column. And if we are looking for error handler, okay, we see several tests here. And those tests are listed here. This is the subset we get. Or maybe we want all tests with priority A and we apply the filter to this column and we get the following list. And once again, we are following some logic, applying some filter, and we get some subsets from our huge set. And you may easily see that some tests may get like this ST.3 into several subsets, and that's absolutely okay. If we are using more modern tool for management of our checklists, test cases and test suites, Jira for instance, we may see the same information in Jira. It's just a simple copy from that Word document file. We see the checklist for the smoke test, we see the checklist for the critical path test. Yes, that's the same information you've already seen a couple of minutes ago. This is how a test case may look like in Jira. You see the title, you see preparations, steps, expected results. You see a lot of other fields here. Most of those fields are filled automatically by Jira itself. You see some attachments here, you see this link, meaning this test case is linked to some requirement. So yes, it's easy, it's fast, it's good. And if we want test suites, I'm using filters. For instance, let's see what do I have in checklists. Let's click and I see checklists for smoke tests and critical path test. How does Jira understand that this is checklist? By using labels. As you see, CL here stands for checklist. If I use another filter, like tests for file operations, I only have one test case here for now, but once again, see the label, file operations. And I may easily create such filters for any labels, for any other fields from these artifacts. And that's extremely useful and convenient. So use it in your everyday working life. Finally, it doesn't really matter what exact tool do you use. I hope you use some modern, convenient, good tool, but the idea is not about the tool. The idea is about the information inside the tool.